gonna do? Well, we're gonna do the engine oil change and engine oil filter. Now, I'm slightly concerned that the filter won't be the right one. It's one I've ordered as a kit, but I don't think they're managing to get the original ones me. So I did the fuel filter one, and it's not right. I've managed to make it do, but it's not the right one really. It'll do its job. So next I want to get into engine oil filter and just see what's happening with that one. Before I go too fast, I want to do it actually the wrong way around. I want to drop the engine oil filter off first before I drop the engine oil and see what we've got. So we'll get on with that. Get a good slot for the camera. I haven't had this off before, so oops, go. It all good. It's good. It's a pretty slot. So that hasn't been off for a long time. I've had it running for 2 minutes and got it warmed up. So this one has the bolt in from the top, not from the bottom. Not sure if that just cracks off or what. Yep, there it comes. Like sludge. What do I want to do? I want to just have a look at that. It's a bit messy, but I've got to do what I've got to do. I'm not sure, but unfortunately, it's going to be a messy job. All we can do is do what we do. It's about the same length. It's a bit mild up, and we haven't got another one of them. Doesn't look like it's been put in right in the first place. But I think it'll still do its job. I'm convinced it will. I see from that. What we'll do, let's take this and give it a clean and then get back to you. I'm blathered up already. Okay, so I've cleaned out the canister. That's all nice and clean now, you can see in there. I'll clean that sprig up a bit. And that washer there, what goes into the bottom of that. So, let's get back on here. And what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to put the filter back on now. Because it didn't make any difference, so I've just done it the opposite way around. That's all. Get a good picture there. So the next thing I want to check is, will that go in there? Yep. Right. So I've got the filter, the canister, and spring. So drop the spring in. I don't know if you can actually see the canister. It's on the spring. So what we need to do now, new bolt. Oh, I didn't new bolt, same bolt. There's a spanner I had now for that one. What's that? Next job, drop the oil out now. Something looks odd about that. Feel of that. not good, that. That is not good. It looks like, I might be wrong, but it looks like somebody's welded a bolt head or a nut onto old something. I think it's gone. It's gone. I'm not impressed with this at all. It's going. Getting looser now, and I don't know if that's going to hold all that lot. I don't think you can even see me from that. There are not many things straightforward doing these old tractors. They just keep throwing obstacles at you. That's a bit of an Eve Robinson, so I took that. Right, we'll leave that to run out. Have a break for a minute. I have to tell if that is a proper thing, but it could be. It just looks a bit Eve Robinson to me. Looks a lot here from it. I don't know if everybody understands what I mean with that. Basically, it looks a bit poor. Alright, so we've cleaned sump plug. As you can see, I think what's happened there is somebody's I might be wrong, but it looks like somebody's ground it down. It probably got gnarled up over time, using spanners on it, and lost its shape, so they've ground it down to that, so. It's pretty much stopped dripping now. It's mixed it out there then. Put it back same way as it came. tight enough for that. Now, one thing I do want to do, give dipstick a clean off. And we're ready for putting some oil back in. So this is what I've got. Some 15W40. What it would have originally had in. Luckily with this I should be able to just pour it in with this nice small cap, small opening up thing. We'll see. Nice and steady away. Now I understand it holds 9 or 10 litres, so we can safely put this one in. And probably save for half the other before we start checking it. So the plan is I want to get all these jobs done while I can, what need doing here, before I put bonnet on. And then when I've got these done, bonnet's going on. And decals, I'm going to put decals up on it once it's on. I think that might be the best way, so we can hold it still. Making my back ache there. That's one. That's one. I don't think there'll be much shoving on here yet. And it's still burning down. Yeah, it's coming up. And then when we start it up, we'll probably lose about a litre into oil filter. Right, next up. Let that settle a minute, we'll just have a quick look. It's actually coming up quite quick though. Give that a minute. That's actually showing it's up to max. So I think what we need to do is put that cap. Keep loading stuff, I'm terrible for it. What we're going to do now, put the stop cable out. turn it over. Settle again and see what it's like at dipstick again. It's just below the max now. Just filter it, we're turning it over with stop on. We filled canister up, oil pressure's popped up. So now we've just got to top it up to the right level then. So it didn't take as much as what I thought it was going to do. I'm guessing, and it is a guess, roughly about a litre. That settle again. Give it a minute. That's all we can do. Give it a wipe. There, just below max, just a little tiny bit more, yeah. Didn't take it long to run down into the sump. It's pretty much bang up maximum. That'll do. Lovely. Lovely. So next thing, start it up. shape. Now I've got to have a clean up. Get all of it first. Catch you soon. Bye.